Hi, what up? Welcome. Glad to have you here. Welcome. Great to be here. And also, yes, salutations and formal greetings, as befit your station. So just imagine that, you know, whatever that is, I covered the bases. It's Midweek Magic Explorer, and I feel like maybe this, the Tuesday stream should start to, like, sort of revolve around the Midweek Magic as a just... because Nelly wants to do magic content, but isn't sure what, so there's a prompt there. But also right now, there's just a million secret layers, so let's get into it. I haven't been on a TTC in a while, and this is, like, what we cover. So I just want to show you what's out there, give my opinion real quick. We'll do the Post Malone bundle. It's gonna take a hot second. Like, there's quite a few. Okay, if I click the picture, does it bring it? Okay, great. Okay, so this is... Okay, there's just two. There's Backstage Pass and the Lands. But if you get a bundle, you get two copies of each, one foil, one non-foil. All four Post Malone drops, which only consists of two sets of art. Okay, so here's all these pretty basic lands that Post Malone has scribbled all over the text box of. That's the thing. If this is what you want, you can have it. You know, like, world-class rapper Post Malone has drawn on these magic cards for you. Yeah, the land art is gorgeous. I don't think it's available without the Post Malone scribbles, though. That would be cool. Yeah, scrawling not for me. Yeah, if you really want it, then you've got it. Good morning, Lady Olinder, Ukon, Manalik, Joker Boney, thank you for driving by. Yeah, the artist credit's pretty great. Drew Tucker and Post Malone, right? Pretty fantastic. Fred Fields and Post Malone. I mean, it's kind of cool for these artists that they have this thing that they can put on the resume, worked with Posty on art. So yeah, I don't know. This is like a weird thing that happened, and I don't know. I think it's cool that it exists. I'm not going to buy it. It's just not for me, but that's okay. I don't want to take away from you. There's a reprint of Crick, which is pretty cool, and it's like very dramatic, sweet art. I assume this is supposed to be Posty as Crick. Like, you can't see his face well enough to be like, it's definitely Post, but the card's called Post. So probably, like, this is Posty and all the art. That would make sense. Or here's Post's neck. That's easy enough to believe. The Jet Medallion is, like, the most normal one. For some reason, they didn't give it its own little name about Posty and then, like, put Jet Medallion underneath. It just says Jet Medallion. I don't know why that's different from the other ones. But anyways, you get a Crick, a Bolas of Citadel, and a Leshrac Sigil, which is, like, a card that I can't even remember seeing before. It's obviously from Ice Age, right? Or Alliances. Oh, yeah, okay. Original art by Drew Tucker, and yeah, fair enough. It's kind—it's a bit like the enchantments that were in Green and Black and Alpha Beta, right? But yeah, this—you get to like duress them whenever they cast a green spell, as opposed to countering the spell, and you can bounce it to your hand for some reason, in case you need to pitch it to Contagion or to keep it alive, I guess. So this is a neat one, just like a full-on old-school harsh color hoser that's extremely mana intensive, very like old-school kind of card. And yeah, I don't know, you get a Crick, like that's, and a Jet Medallion, I guess. I'm not sure if Jet Medallion is still expensive, but Crick hasn't been reprinted a ton, so if you want the Crick and you like Post Malone, probably it's worth snapping off, because I think, I don't know, what is Crick worth right now? By, oh god, I can't even spell it without looking at it, can I? No, of course I can't. K apostrophe R R I K. MTG. TCG player says. Yeah, $15. So like, or more maybe, you know, like, so that pays for most of. Oh, he's in the same position. I see. Okay, it's just Posty dressed up as Crick. Cool. All right, so that's the Post Malone one. Super cool that they put that together, and pretty quickly, honestly, since like Post came out as a Magic player and they started producing content with like playing community college and stuff. Pretty quickly done. Jet Medallone was right there. Yeet the Rich, good call. Absolutely. Yeah, I would also want to collab with Magic if you're that rich. Yeah, good call. Good call, Eolinder. I didn't know that Pokemon had claimed Ed Sheeran, but I think that's sweet. Yeah. Yeah, for sure. I mean, the Post Malone Commander deck obviously like goes in some powerful shit. Like you did, it's good cards. Like Bolas of Citadel is great. They made a promo Bolas of Citadel, and it wasn't like a huge important card in any Eternal formats really. Like, so it's just still cheap, I believe. Could double check that. But first, let's go to Card Kingdom, because you know that's where I'd rather be shopping. Sorry, this is where I'd rather be shopping for my cards. If I'm gonna be shopping for cards, what does it cost to buy a Bolas of Citadel? What about a Bolas's Vitadel? You can pay up to $7 or $8 for a really fancy one. Oh no, the median is like $7 now. Okay, fair enough. Last time I checked in on this card, I have one, but last time I checked it was $1, so. That's actually relevant. This is like, so between those two cards, you have like most of the price of the secret lair. So the post secret lair with the spells is actually like a totally fine deal. I think you're covered. Because Jet Medallion is probably at least $5. Unless they just put it in like three commander decks at once. Oh my god. Really? No. It's been that long, hey? Because I remember when this came out. Because this one, Like, it was only in Tempest for the longest time. And yeah, this price tag is in my memory. It started to be like 20, 25 bucks in like 2013 or something when Commander started to pop up. But like, what? Oh yeah, 2014. It hasn't been printed since 2014, almost 10 years ago now. Wild. Because I remember selling these to Yellow Jacket. We'd crack open some decks and we sold these for like $3 or something in 2014. So, okay, I changed my mind. If you need a Jet Medallion, definitely buy that Post Malone Secret Lair, because you can just sell the other cards for most of the price of the Jet Medallion. Maybe that's why they did it. Maybe they were like, we just want to give them a Jet Medallion. It's going to have Posty art, but we want to sell to the people who like Posty and the people who don't give a fuck. Yeah. Yeah. Okay, so that's news. Joker, thanks for stopping by. Nice. Okay, well, I look forward to seeing your Canlander lists. Okay, moving on. There's a whole bunch of Warhammer 40k cards. I don't know if I want to do all the price crunching on this one. I just want to show them off a little bit. But we've got, and they're in a few different box sets, but you can get them all in the bundle. We've got Merciless Executioner, aka Fleshbag Marauder, right? 3 mana, 3-1, ETB, everybody sex creature. So that one's like, you can get for real cheap. So this is just if you like orcs in 40k and you just want to have this. Aggravated Assault, I don't think it's super expensive, but is like a played commander card. So, you know, it gives you extra combat phases for as often as you want for 5 mana, which can go infinite with some stuff. And the art's great. I mean, the treatment of these is fantastic. I don't know the 40k lore, so that's clearly who they're sending these to. But you get a Krenko, which is like a Canadian Highlander played card. So that's cool. And then you also get a Zergal Helmstricker. And I think this is where it switches to a different one. New printing of Sky Sovereign, which is actually fairly played in Modern. So, like, that's worth a couple bucks for sure. Blind Obedience, good card for a commander. Danitha Capuchin, I don't know. I'm not sure if she has really found a home in Canadian Highlander. I'm not sure if there is, like, an equipment deck that uses her. I'm certainly not a card that's super on my radar. But Najeela the Blood Blossom, really cool-looking Archaon, the Everchosen, are here. Najeela is, like, a powerful red deck wins card. For Commander, you can have Stardrake instead of Scourge of the Throne. This card was expensive, but I feel like they put it in something and got cheap again. But for a while, Scourge of the Throne was like a really sought-after card. So yeah, money-wise, this one might be worth it. You can get a Loxodon Warhammer. This is the first card that I learned to draft higher than equipment. Like, this was the first draft format I got into, was Mirrodin, Triple Mirrodin. And I passed one of these, and the you know, the 15-year-old kids at the table wouldn't let me hear the end of it. Oh, there's no Olinder. Olinder is your name comes from a 40k character. I didn't know that. That's neat. Okay, then we move into Blood Bowl, which I actually did play, so I'm familiar with some of these situations. In fact, I played one of the decks that does a lot of flinging, the trees and kobolds, or trees and little goblins, or whatever. Like, there's like one tree ant or ant creature, like a tree folk creature that like hucks the other goblins while they're carrying the ball. But you get Touchdown, Purge of the Second Sun, Rewind, which is called Reroll, which I think is really cute. Bone Splinters, which is trading two creatures. So none of these are, like, very expensive cards or fling. It's all just for the art. It's just if you love Blood Bowl and you play these cards and you want to have them. Except you get a Defense of the Heart. Sorry, Defense of the Heart's actually pretty expensive. Or has been. Is this the second printing of Defense of the Heart? No, it must have been in something. It's been in a Commander box, right? It's been in something else. Really, it was just a promo. Wild. Oh, it's on the list. That's what it is. Right. The printing, the existence of the list is so hard for, like, shopkeeps or finance people, I imagine, to predict. I am mystified. I don't understand, like, because there wasn't as much Mystery Booster as we thought, and then also, like, the list cards are in, like, some set packs, but there's so many cards on the list that, like, it's hard to figure out whether this reprint really matters. Anyway, so yeah, okay, so there's only been, really, a Judge promo, the list, and now a Secret Lair, so yeah, your Defense of the Heart's worth something. And then lastly, you get a Felwar Stone called the Ball. I don't think Felwar Stone is very expensive, but it's very cute. Like, and, like, great energy on the art, too, right? Okay, that is the Warhammer 40k stuff. Okay, there's more. There's so much more still. There's so many Secret Lairs right now. Secret Lair. If looks could kill, there's a High Fashion Haute Couture Secret Lair by artist Jack Hughes. Who I'm not super familiar with, illustrator Jack Hughes, maybe they've done comic books or magazines or something, but absolutely gorgeous. You get Azami with these incredible scrolls floating all over her. Liliana of the Dark Realms, like, with six arms, looking like a Hindu god, kind of, with a big, big fluffy boa. Reflector Mage with three heads. Who's that like? I'm trying to remember. Like Zaphod Beeblebrox a little bit or whatever. And a hole in his hand. Like, very, very hot Reflector Mage. And then you get Adaptive Automaton, also with kind of the, like, forward-facing, side-facing different heads motif. It's different characters in the art, other people, but there's sort of a connection there. And these are all, like, good cards for two-player games for the most part. I mean, the Zami, pretty rare that you put in a Canadian Highlander deck, but... And I guess same with Liliana. But Reflector Mage, for sure, it's in some lists. And Adaptive Automaton, still totally fine whenever you're playing Tribal. Yeah. Oh, Jack Hughes is a fashion designer? Okay, cool. They got credit as an illustrator here, but maybe we're supposed to know who Jack Hughes was before coming in. Money-wise, this one seems totally fine. You know, you get a Planeswalker, and you get a good commander, and you get cards that are played, and it's gorgeous. I don't know if I need to pick this one up. I'm thinking about it, though. It's just very pretty. Okay, Junji Ito, you've probably already seen. This one's pretty exciting. You know, manga artist Junji Ito giving us these incredible black and white treatments for Plague Crafter, Doomsday, Carrion Feeder, and Thoughtseize. These ones don't, like, this art style doesn't grab me as much. Like, no disrespect, I think it looks great. I just don't know if I'm gonna go for this. I do love black cards, though, so I'm considering it. I don't know, maybe I should try to find out some more about Junji Ito's work to trick myself into spending $30 on this. But, you know, the Thoughtseize is the expensive one. Doomsdays are rare, so, like, it's probably worth a couple bucks. It's been in... Doomsdays is a funny card where it's, like, an important element of Legacy and gets played in some Canadian Highlander decks. But I think it's, like, it's so few and far between the people build the decks that I don't think the card itself is worth that much. Okay, the original is up to $10. That's the highest I've seen it. And then there was a Masterpiece. Master 25 one's a little more expensive. Yeah, okay, fair enough. So a couple bucks because they just haven't printed it very often. You know, Weatherlight was a long time ago, and then it was a Mythic in Masters. Oh, really? Is the popular Commander card? I didn't know that. Somewhere Wheeler is pogging. Art Brief for Doomsday, an apocalypse of your own creation. Yeah. No, there's no doubt that these cards look fantastic. Like, yeah. I'm more excited about this other special guest edition. Yoji Shinkawa, video game artist... from Metal Gear, right, among other things, probably, and a bunch of cards that I play, like, pretty much could just take this and, like, put it into the deck. Like, right now, I have both of these cards in the Canadian Highlander deck that I played last night, and this card could also be in there, maybe, probably not, this particular one, because there's not a lot of basic lands at all, but this kind of value robot, and then Skull Clamp, obviously, like, played in a million things. They really gave Yoji Shinkawa just, like, okay, we're gonna make sure you only paint cards that people play a ton. Like, obviously, this one, just, like, super commander staple. These two should be as well. And then Skull Clamp. I'm actually not even positive that this is cards legal in Commander. It probably is, right? If it is, you should be playing it, and probably people are. So just, like, just a absolute home run in terms of the cards that they were given. Yeah, it looks so much like Liquid Snake, exactly. Yeah, same idea. So I'll probably buy this one. I don't know. It's cards I already own, but, like, you know, you can get... It's, like, not that much money to spend on Magic cards. And then there's three more still, somehow. Okay, Space Beyond the Stars is this sort of trippy Jeremy Solomon one. I don't entirely understand the inspiration. It's sort of loosely related to Unfinity, I guess, because they're in space. You get Imprisoned the Moon, Stasis, Prismaticum, and Wheel of Sun and Moon. Four enchantments, all with these, like... groovy, sort of cosmic, minimalist, kind of like Era of Enlightenment vibe of the drawings. You know, like, have you seen the music video for Tonight by Smashing Pumpkins? This is a bit of the vibe. I don't know what Prismatic Omen or Wheel of Sun and Moon costs, or Stasis, or Imprison the Moon can't be more than $5, right? That's more recent. Although... it does a lot of things. This one might be worth it. I'm not going to look into it because I just don't need these cards. Weirdest Pet in the Multiverse. Omar Ryan. I don't know. I'm so curious what started this. Whether someone saw Omar Ryan's drawing and was just like, we need to give him more teeth. Just make sure he gets to draw lots of teeth. But yeah, you get a Lab Maniac, Stitch Supplier, a Beast Whisperer, a Vizier of the Magerie, and a Wood Elves. with this incredible sort of, I don't know, it reminds me a little bit of Where the Wild Things Are. Their style, I'm not sure what else Omar Rayan has painted, but I recognize the name, so it's got to be a couple things that I liked. Yeah, Ugly Babies, exactly. It's, like, very cute and doesn't take itself seriously. Like, the name the card is Wood Elves, and the flavor text is But Should Elves. Right? Stitcher Supplier says, Heal! Wait, no. Fetch the whole leg! Attributed to Stitcher Gerolf. So this one's, like, incredibly cute. And lastly, Totally Spaced Out Galaxy Foil Edition. You have to spend $50 because there's no non-foil. Oh, they charged a bit more than a regular one for four cards, too. But it's all lands, and it's, like, lands you're going to play, like Strip Mine and Fabled Passage. Foil, shiny, like, you know, the little dots are, like, popping out, sort of vaguely 3D. And, like, your lands look like they're from space. And you get a Command Beacon and Ashburns, too. So, I don't know. I'm thinking about this one, and I'm thinking about the Junji Ito, or the Yoji Shinkawa one. That's where we're at with that. Get out of there. Get in there. Yeah, I just wanted to walk you through that and see if anybody had questions or opinions. Do people not play Strip Mine enough in Commander? It's weird. Yeah, I agree they should play it. It's really good. It's a really good card. Okay, we have an Explorer deck. Let's get some free stuff for playing match cards. All right, Tigger. Nothing Fable? I'd rather accelerate. I should be so lucky. This hand is actually, like, a little bit more exciting than the last hand, just because we have one turn to hit Courier's Briefcase, and then we can Transmogrify. No? All right. At least we had this in here. Ukon puts you down a land to deal with their land, though. Yeah, it does. It's your choice, though, right? Like, Strip Mine doesn't force you to cast a Stone Rain. It just gives you the option. Yeah, I'm sitting today, hey, buddy? All right. Sitting today. A little tiny bit of Nyssa content. Okay, what did we do with this otherworldly land? Oh, we just pitched it. Yeah, let's pitch some stuff. What am I doing? Oh, they killed my token. Okay. Do I want to burn their token too? Is that how I'm playing this? Are they also just going to transmogrify on their turn? I just want to keep my stuff. Yeah, good doggo. Our transmog just hits Titan. The new Capenna Titan. And we can also cast it. Yeah, we're not being, like, super greedy. Think this is right. We don't want to let this attack for free. Thank you. Maybe we'll crew this first. Okay, let's destroy an enchantment. And we need to make a 4-4 rhino. This one. Yeah. Well, okay, so we're playing Explorer right now. So Explorer only uses the original paper printed cards and just has a banned list. We're not playing Historic, which uses the rebalanced cards, or Alchemy, which uses the rebalanced cards. But the midweek magic this week is Explorer, the newest Eternal format to hit Arena, and it uses only, like, the same exact cards you can find in paper. It's impossible to know it's playable. Yeah. Yeah, a little bit, yeah. It's a lot to keep track of, honestly. Like, yeah, I don't know. I still just think Alchemy was a mistake, and they should... They are just playing! Yeah, they're playing, like, the bigger, greedier Transmogrify. Okay, so they let's find out what they're hitting. Yep. Scary. If they get protection from creatures... Oh, yeah, that's good. They just take my Kiki and my Titan, maybe? Yeah, that's okay. Awkward! Getting foisted by my own petard here. So we can do this and this, or we can do this. I think we have to. We're very, very incentivized to do this. And burn their Kiki Cheeky. Our Eskas can't really attack, which is too bad. We don't need this courier's briefcase, though, so that's nice. We can keep that in hand to discard it. Hey, thanks very much, TPZ. Yeah, it's not bad so far. Okay. Jeskai gives you Wedding Announcement. Wedding Announcement is a more exciting card than Courier's Briefcase, but this deck isn't ever polymorphing on turn 3. Interesting. Yeah, I think I'm just going to block their Titan. Okay, I want to attack first. Now, I want to burn their Kiki-Jiki again. I wonder if I want to use this just so I have one more chump. Like, if I have two blockers, does it make any difference? They just have to attack with three? No, it doesn't matter. Yeah, we're trading this Chandra for Reflection. It's fine. Ran into that earlier this week. Goldspan Dragon God's removal punishing clause back in Historic Brawl, I think. Oh, really? Did they... Yeah, I don't really play Historic Brawl, but I assume it uses the same rules as Historic. So... If you were playing in Explorer, you'd fight a Goldspan Dragon that was just like the original. Have to hope that these treasures don't really matter. Although they're playing creativity, so like it's one more thing they can target. But I just don't want these to get flickered. Okay. Indomitable's not an instant, is it? No, okay, cool. I was all talk saying I was going to discard this. Now I have a 7 drop, so I need to play this. Tigger, are you thinking about how to wreck me, or are you thinking about scooping? Okay, nice, I love it. All right. Aw, thanks, CD Mac. Yeah. Well, it'd be nice. Maybe someday we'll have a channel of all just can't land her. Alright. Nice. I don't know if I had one of these yet. Sweet. Each creature and each opponent. And then the same clause. Or no, better than Fable, because you only do up to 2, right? And then you get a 4-4. Yeah, I mean, this isn't Fable of the Mirror Breaker, but kind of a cool card. Fair, yeah. I missed the Gladiator Q too. Gladiator Q! Come back to me, Gladiator Q! This is good enough that we keep. It doesn't transmogrify. Hey, no, you don't touch the keyboard, pal. There you go. I made some space for you. There you go. You can have some keyboard tray, just not the keyboard itself. Whoa. Oh yeah, this deck. Nice. I mean, yeah, let's do this one. It's like, this one's actually more flimsy. Yeah, I think the Gladiator Q was the most I played in Arena ever, Lady Alinder. Someone did say Gladiator little effects. Oh, you just wrapped up the finals of the latest Gladiator tournament season this weekend? Yeah. Bring the Q back! That's right, little effects. Oh, that's good against me. Okay. Right? Nice. You just get to play this main in this deck. Hot. Okay. Well, I could see putting this in my hand and doing this. Sure, actually. I don't know. Do we want to just Voltage Surge this Patchwork Automaton instead of putting Kihira in hand? That's probably better. Yeah, let's just do that main. It's Ward 2? Yeah, sure. think I might have this deck sleeved up too. Hi, little effects. Oh, Effie. It's Effie. Okay, cool. Right. Yes, I've copied your lists and watched your streams. Brr. Let's do it. That's tough to decide. I think this one's probably right. Do we mind trading? Yeah, we have a backup Essica. We can trade Essica for Michiko. That's okay. Ooh, Judge's Tower. No, I'd love to play Judge's Tower. I thought we were playing Infinity Draft, but maybe we'll do both. Have I played Mono Blue Delver in Standard? No. No, TPC. I haven't played any Standard since like two sets ago, actually. Yeah, fair enough. Shout out Sodom Bruchette for sure. Yeah. That's a good one. Yeah, no, Infinity is some fun times, Manalik. You're going to judge it. Oh, Infinity Judge's Tower? Did Wheeler mention that? Is that what we're doing? Instead of draft? Are we just like putting some Infinity cards into the Judge's Tower? Or building an Infinity Judge's Tower? And playing that format? God. Yeah. F's in chat. Like, that sounds hard. I haven't played Judge's Tower since before the pandemic, for sure. Ooh, if we rip any land, we can Transmogrify on three. Seems right. That's a land. Ooh, that's a pretty Blood Crypt. Wow, this person paid for the space duels. Yeah, I'm thinking about it. This is another secret lair you can buy, right? Yo, Effie, thanks so much. Appreciate it. Some reasonable cards are Judge Towers? Yeah. Yeah, these are so pretty. This is tapped, right? Yeah, it's too bad. Okay, that's okay. What did they do? Oh, they just killed my 1-1? Oh, wow, that's bad for me, actually. I needed that 1-1. Okay. Well, okay, so I could use the treasure to make Essica, or I could use treasure to make Fable, or I could just play Bugbear tapped and do nothing. I could play Fable and then also play the Bugbear so that next turn I can still Transmogrify. That's actually pretty good. Sure. Let's do that. Yeah, no, I'm into it too. I mean, we're meeting together again. We should play Judge Tower at some point. Mm. Shoutouts to Effie. Hey, if you're not already following Little FX Radio, or Gladiator, is it? Sorry, what's the account called? I know I'm following it already. Is it Gladiator Games on Twitch? It's Gladiator MTGA, isn't it? You want to follow Gladiator MTGA? Yes, yes. Follow that account to get the. Good Saturday morning commentated casts of Gladiator. I guess just Eska here. Okay, don't follow Little Effects Radio. Just, you know, copy their deck list on the Gladiator Discord. All right. Good. I guess we're just shield countering here. Shields up. My dog's giving me the big eyes. Sorry, she's just off camera, team. I've tried to fix that. I've tried to have her, like, have a pet cam before, but lately, like, I'm mostly streaming from the desk while it's a standing desk, like, from the raised desk. And she just, like, whenever I'm standing up here, she's just like, nah, I'm just gonna go downstairs and look out the window. She's, like, not interested in hanging out with me if I'm not, like, also a chair for her. Is your shower played face up? No. You do have your hand hidden. Although, like, it doesn't really help. Honestly, like, Judge's Tower might as well be played face up, because you sort of want your friends to, like, you want your opponents or whatever to help you and point out when you messed up if you, yeah, you know? Alright, fair enough. Okay, we finished that. Sweet. Ooh, pretty. That was a lucky one to get, hey? Nice. I would have considered paying for that. Sweet. Caves of plot. Okay, let's check the store real quick. Speaking of paying for things, see if there's any sweet goodies. Oh yeah, a cheap pack. Sure. We got one of the ones that was in the store right now. Oh, you can get the rest of the lands. Oh, yeah, I gotta get this one. I don't know about the rest of them. The Shivan Reef's nice. I do play a lot of blue-red. There's two blue ones. I just, like, need to respect my friend in the bath. Are the bubbles moving around a little bit, or am I drunk? It seems like they wobble a bit, hey? The little gas bubbles. Yeah, it's really, really expensive for these card sales. You're right. The game is really, like, really in the throes of just trying to squeeze as much out of us as humanly possible right now. And, I mean, fair enough. Like, we live in a capitalism. You know, that's what every company is supposed to be doing, whether they know it or not, right? Just try to squeeze, right? Doesn't feel good. It's five times as much to get 10... Shocklands as I just paid for a single Sulphurous Springs that I was, like, emotionally attached to. I have the coins, so I might pull that off. We've got a minute to decide. It's even more for the basics, eh? These basics are so pretty, but also so expensive. God, look at this plains. Isn't that messed up? Yeah, okay. Can I afford to pull a trigger on both these? Not anymore. I have to pay. I'm gonna pay the game. Okay, we're gonna take a break. We need to stretch our legs. You probably want to do the same. Maybe move your fluids around. Nissa's got to go outside. Does not smell good in the studio right now. So we'll be back probably 5 minutes. And then when we get back, we're going to try this new-ish draft format. Super curious about this, actually. I've been thinking about it more. It's not Alchemy. When I saw, like, weird new Capenna, and because Alchemy, Dominaria, United Draft is also on right now. But this is, hey, we fixed new Capenna draft. Which is, like, a cool thing that they can do on Arena, right? Like, they, with Throne of Eldraine, they just fixed the bots because it was, like, the blue deck was too good. So they just fixed the bots. But with New Capenna, they just went in and changed the cards. Yeah. Get some more coffee. Stretch your legs. See you in 5 minutes, team.
thought so when I read Singer. I'm going homeward bound, Federal Highway. Lost my head, then I lost my head. Give me to win, I need to win. Through the bush today, I couldn't keep my mind from political debates. I feel it's embraced, that's who I am now. I am a legal type with hips to hate. Finally found a music girl, but I'm caught up in the antique words. I'm in an anxious state, she just can't connect.
Okay, tired dad, back at it. In this plane shift draft, many of the cards from streets have been... Oh, we can't see anything. Shoot. How about now? Okay, great. Many of the cards from streets have been rebalanced, creating an alternative look in this draft at this draft format. Figure out which families are depending on power, and you could rule in your capenna. Select one card. Yeah, okay. Let's try it. Hopefully the cue fires. I think this is a good idea, and this is like a thing that's it's useful that Arena is doing. I missed why, and that's why you only spent 30 minutes in the hot tub. I don't know what that was about, Lady Olinder, but fair enough. I heard 20 minutes is what you should be doing. Judging from other games you play, Arena could be worse. Yeah, it could be worse. It's slowly been getting slowly worse and worse. Yeah, it'd be nice if we had a spectator mode, obviously. It'd be nice if we could run tournaments. Oh, I need to turn a light off just a second. Oh, it's the sulfur springs. Yeah. What up, Arcade Hamster? Thanks for coming by. Okay. All right, TPZ and Ucon maybe helping each other out. Good. Okay, we're waiting a while for this queue to fire. I get it. People were burned. Now they're twice careful about this format. I gotta cut the stream a bit short today because I have the dentist. Fun, right? My dentist is pretty chill. It's gonna be okay. But yeah, we'll definitely get to finish the draft in maybe at least one game. Assuming we get one more. I'm cold all of a sudden, too. It's getting to be that time of year. All right. Come have a cozy Nelly stream. He's not playing a cozy game. But he is a cozy person. The overall review of the Secret Lairs was the special guest Yoji Shinkawa and Jinji Ito ones are pretty crazy. Those are pretty stacked. And then also, I didn't know Jet Medallion was $50 now. So maybe buy the Post Malone one with the Jet Medallion. And then otherwise, yeah, I mean, what else can you say except, like, if this is for you, then you should grab it. I wanted to point out that the Yoji Shinkawa one is probably for me. And then, was there one? There was one more I was going to maybe get to. Oh, right, the Foil Galaxy non-basic lands, Strip Mine and Fabled Passage one. I might also get that one. You thought it was Coachy Nelly? Nice one, Evil Mono. Yeah. I don't know, maybe I'm supposed to buy the Post Malone one just because I don't own a Crick yet. Like, I don't know if I want that Crick. I might want the original Crick more. Okay, please click, everyone. I know I've been waiting for a long time. Okay, so far my review of this draft queue is, it's great that they tried to rebalance New Capenna to, like, put some life back into that format. However, it maybe wasn't worth... Oh, this blanket is green. Damn it. Invisibility cloak, Nelly. it maybe wasn't worth all the time that you have to put into getting a draft to fire, because it's too late, right? This is like a full set ago that they're fixing. If they want to do these rebalances, maybe they have to do them like the first week or something, which is a crazy amount of work to expect anyone to do, but oh, come on, are we going to get there? Nope. Brutal. Brutal. Okay. Yeah, I don't know if I'm going to put myself through this again. Maybe if it's really, really fun. I wonder if the consensus is just going to be like, yeah, it's rebalanced. Now Bant is the best deck, but only by a little. Okay, this is the same. This card's kind of cool. Yep. This is the same. This is fixed. Right, this used to be the 3-drop, right? And now it's a 5-drop? Okay. This is the same. This is 4 mana instead of 3. And it's a sorcery. I think it might have been an instant before. I don't know. Is Entourage better than Ognis? Like, this is kind of hard to cast. I don't mind getting into the Hammer people. Hammer bros. I could also see either of these flyers. This new 5 mana 3-3 that used to be a 3 mana 2-3. Like, I don't know. My favorite is just the Entourage. Oh, it used to be a 3-1. Right. Was it a 3 mana 3-1? Or was it a 4 mana 3-1? I'm thinking of the other one. I'm thinking of the regulator that was the 3 mana 2-3. Oh, this one's kind of cool. What's the Capenna Express now? Now the Capenna Express is a 7-7. Okay, so they buffed this. They also buffed this. Did they buff this? No, they nerfed this, didn't they? I could see being on this one. I don't hate the fixer. I don't hate this one either. But we're sort of maybe trying to aim to be in Naya. We could just grab this one too. Honestly, like I haven't seen this ability trigger all that often. I think I just like the fixer the most here. Rigo's pretty good. Yeah, fair enough. This got fixed a bit, hey, to be the same as that new Bad Bone Splitter. I can't remember what this was before. Well, Do we just want to grab Echo Inspector and get off this plan? Or this one? This pack's a little bit... I don't care about it. Rogues Gallery is good sometimes. It could be Jund and have Rogues Gallery. Or just take the Racer's Ring. I'm thinking right now between the Racer's Ring and the Flyers. I think this is my favorite. I'll just lose my Jetmir's Fixer pick. Arena agrees, yeah. What the heck's the getaway car again? Ooh, the haste one. Right, we have to bounce the creatures that crewed it. So this is actually probably pretty good at Naya, right? Where you can, if you have some cheap creatures, or anything with an ETB is pretty sweet. Run out of town. They buff this? I don't remember what that one did before then. Oh, there's a Ravenous Rats. Appraiser's really good. We could be on Appraiser and then we play our Echo Inspector in that deck. I think maybe we'll just take the car. Maybe this will table, then we can put that thing in the car. Oh, Fox of Doom, hello. Hello, welcome. All right, and I'm so sorry for you. Yeah, this is like a pretty rough addiction to get into. Might destroy your life. Estrange you from your family. I hope not.
I hope it goes well for you. But yeah, watch out. These are it's powerful magics you're playing with. Yeah, I'm okay. You know, I've been playing since the 90s though, so I have that problem. I think we just light him up here. First light him up is better than first sledge arsonist, right? This thing is like the ceiling's higher, but. There's a crew captain chilling. Okay, it looks like maybe Jund is where it's going to be at. Rather than Naya. Someone next to us wants to be green-white, right? So we're getting red-black cards. We haven't really been passing anything green yet. Yeah, maybe we should even just cut both these green cards and end up being Grixis. This card's pretty messed up, though. Like, we could just plan to be Jund. Yeah, playables. What did this get? This got an extra point of power or something, didn't it? What did this get? It was always you pay to have Death Touch. It was always two mana, wasn't it? Another fixer. Oh, all three of these lands are here too. We don't have any ways to get treasures yet. That's okay. We're gonna have some kind of aggressive deck. Okay, this is here. That's good. I want one of these artifacts. This is a treasure. This card's playable. Is this the same? Yeah. Yeah, ads exist. I'm a treasure. Yeah. Twitch streamers are all putting up more ads now because they're paying us to put up ads, and they're not paying us as they're not giving us a better cut of subs. So I don't know what to tell you. Yeah, it's like we're sort of like pushed to run much more ads. I'm doing that. It's not outside of my knowledge. So, and I'm not apologizing. That ads is how it goes, friends. Okay, well, we have to take Pug, but we're hoping Kaldiah will table. That's probably a little greedy. Maybe one of these two will table. But yeah, you gotta take this Pug. Yeah, we can take this, right? You gain 3 life now. Sweet. Ooh, Genie Fae. Hmm.
the Swindler. They put this in here entirely for flavor. Make your own death. Glittermonger. Glittermonger's a 2/4 now. They buffed Glittermonger. Do we have to take Glittermonger? Or do we have to take Jennifer? Jennifer is actually kind of hard to cast for us. It's green, green, red for our mana base. And, like, we're a little stretched already. We're looking like green, red, splash, black. Honestly, think that Glittermonger is doing more for us for where the deck is right now than Jennifer. Okay, the Connoisseur is good. Jewel Thief is incredible. Riveteer's Charm? No, we just take Jewel Thief here. This land's good for us. There's also a Roastmaster. And the Rakish Revelers. You only have to pay one now for this? Instead of two? Well, that's hot. Jeez. I guess it's this, but it's close. Well, there's another one here. Okay. It's also a Plasma Jockey. Incriminate only costs one now. One mana, you sacrifice your second best creature. Is that better than fixing my lands a bit? Maybe. There's also this Reach. Five mana, 4/5. I want this. It's like, it's a red-green duel that then eventually turns into a 5/3 and a 1/1. This is also a red-green duel. Sinless Package. What did they change here? They used to only give you one treasure? Or you didn't use to scry one. That's what it is, right? Yeah, I'll grab the Stimulus Package, I think. We've already got, like, some payoffs for treasure. We could get a third payoff for treasure, or we could get the friend who likes to get into the car. I don't even know if I'm going to keep that car. I'm gonna try to be red-green treasures. Ooh, this tabled. That's fantastic. Okay, we've got a deck. The Scry one's new, yes. You get to keep the regular... You get to keep, like, whatever it is that you drafted, I think. Okay, well, do we want the big pump spell or the little pump spells? Let's grab this thing. I don't know if we're going to play it, but let's put that in our stack. We might end up playing it. I want to try this card out. I feel like one mana for this effect is maybe worth... Yeah, thanks, Fox. Yeah. Honestly, if you're downloading Arena for the first time, play through the tutorial. Like, you've never played Magic before. Just keep clicking. Once you get through all they make you play a bunch of games to unlock all of the decks. And then once you've done that, I would suggest playing an aggressive red deck on the ladder. So you want to play standard ranked. And then just put all your best red cards together that costs, like, 3 mana or less. Start there, and then see what other people are playing and copy them. Ooh, we got a War Chief. That's sweet. Also a Rocco in this pack. Another Fixer and another Jewel Thief. So we might table a Jewel Thief for a murder. Not super likely. Okay, I think this Join the Maestros doesn't get played now that we have this thing. Are we playing all these 5 drops? Yeah. Oh, right, this isn't one. Okay. What's the cleanup crew again? 6 mana, 6/6. All right. Cool. Ooh. This card's really neat. I don't know if we have the setup for it. But I also don't know if we want just another 6 mana 6/6 out of this pack. We could Nightclubber. This card's really good. Our deck wouldn't mind one of these. I don't know. What's our creature count? 13 right now? I like that it has Trample Haste. The stats on their own aren't that amazing, though. Are we trying it? I mean, we've got the getaway car. Maybe the valet gets in the getaway car, right? Makes sense. Stockpile. Make a treasure when it dies. Friend. Another racer's ring. Yeah, sure. Let's make our mana a bit better. We can blitz the nightclubber into the getaway car. Oh, right. The getaway car is really good with blitz, right? I just haven't taken a lot of blitz creatures. I've been just taking the treasure cards instead. There's a prize fight here. We probably need that, hey?
Security rocks isn't as good as prize fight, is it? Our removal suite's pretty short. We don't have a lot of removal. We have a lot of creatures. Okay. We've got freelance muscle though. Could get another deal gone bad. Got 3 5 drops already. Sure. What's this one? Oh. Okay. I didn't get a strangle, hey? Yeah. I think I just want another land instead of a 5-mana removal spell. Second stimulus package. Second Riveteers. First Pummeler. I think we just put second stimulus package on the board. I don't know. Is second stimulus package better than first Glittermonger? I don't think so. Incriminate and Goldhound are both kind of like doing their best to not turn into a 5-drop. Like, I could cut both those 1-drops and just play like stimulus package in one of these. How good is Take to the Streets again? Everything gets +2/+2, and your citizens get +1/+1 vigilance. And I have a few citizens. Another Stronghorn or a first Sledge Arsonist. Oh, I like both these cards. We are set up to profit from this one. This card, I believe, is the same. It just has a third toughness, but this card's just better. Yeah. Sorry, Sledge Arsonist. Fourth Fixer. I guess so, hey? Okay, we gotta make a couple of cuts. I guess we're playing this. We should probably cut that. We don't actually have any white sources or white pips in our deck. These are a little more like 4-drops. I don't know if the valley is making the cut. And we need one more cut. Maybe just the fourth fixer isn't in. I don't know if I want to cut this antagonize. I sort of want to give Goldhound a shot. Yeah, maybe we just can't play 4 fixers. All right, medium confident. Sorry, I didn't take that. Bear 6875 asked if it's Ghost Draft. No, it's not. It's not Phantom Draft. It's just that a bunch of these cards are different now. Ugh. Yeah, well, the raccoons have an extra point of toughness. I mean, 3. Oh, yeah, these have been buffed. These have been buffed, too. All of them, I think, cost 1 instead of 2. They fixed all of these to be better. It was, like, a pretty serious overhaul. Like, you know, you're not going to draft a deck without any of these, I think. It's so many cards. Oh, we should name it. Sorry. Coachy Streamer. Okay, Ukon asked an interesting question. How many games does Incriminate get to be OpSac's second best thing and not OpSac's worst thing without us just dying to death? It's a fair question. It's as many games as they only have 2 creatures, I suppose, hey? Sorry, yeah, but Bear was asking if this is Ghost Draft. It's not Ghost Draft. Did I answer that? I hope so. Sweet. Let us Let us be friends. I like it. Yeah. Could get a second green man out of here. Well, they can't pump, hey? Yeah, all right. I mean, they could have a spell, obviously, but I'll trade Fixer for a spell. Oh no, that's a good card. What did they change? Was it Ward 1 and now it's Ward 2? There's so many subtle little changes to these rebalances that I just like don't remember at all. Wish this was still instructable. Oh well. I mean, I think we're definitely spending 4 mana this turn, so just, like, playing this is probably fine. And then attacking with both is probably fine. Yeah, okay, they didn't block at all. Are we casting this and just pumping this once? Oh, no, we can't because we played Lauren Lion. I think we're just casting this. Yeah, just take 6. Then we just cast this. We have this up. We'd rather not have to cast it, but it's fine. Yep. Yeah, we should let that happen. One, two, three. We could get him for 5 here. What if we go pump, pump, prize fight? Do we have enough mana to get through Ward 2? No, we certainly don't. That's okay. Almost, hey? Yeah. We're just gonna play the initiate. I think we're supposed to kill the flyer. And then we have... Yeah, we should have just enough mana. Well, we could just cast this first. Yeah, it's fine. Word two, right? I don't know, maybe this is supposed to attack? Oh, it just didn't have ward. Oh, okay, thanks. Thanks, Clash. Clash Owen Bash. Yeah. That's coming down next turn, eh?
Yeah. 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 7, yeah. All right. Annoying. Ooh. But you don't have any cards in hand, so you're milling one. Okay. So, like, can we make this a 7-7 yet? 1, 2, 3, I guess. Ooh, the getaway car. Is that good here? I don't think so. We don't have any creatures that do anything. Just have to pay for it. But it is a 4-3. Haste. Okay, so either we could shove with a 4-3 haste and keep everyone else home, or attack with Rivadier. But then it just trades with Silencer. I don't love that. Okay, so we could just plunge with just the getaway car. Or we could attack with the Fixer, and we can do +2/+2 easily enough, or plus a treasure. So say we're threatening a 7-7 with a treasure. Is that good? Yeah, I think so. I think it's fine. Is this right? 3? Yeah. So they probably double block and we trade a shield counter and a hypnotic grifter. I think that's okay. Yeah. This card's going to be really relevant in like 2 turns. So I think it's okay. We don't even have to pump. We can just play this after combat, right? Because we're only getting the shield counter, right? We just deal 3. Yeah. We can't get it to 9 power, so we don't even have to pump. Okay.
Yeah. Okay. This is a combo, right? Yeah. I mean, probably this one. Oh, wait, I was supposed to target this, wasn't I? Shoot. Okay, right. I messed up the combo. Because we want to crew this thing twice, don't we? Now, what up, Meebo gang? Nope. There is a cool name for you. You had a collective nod. I remember asking before. Meeb Squad? Anyways, welcome. What up, Skylar? Were you playing Magic? Were you playing Valorant this morning? Go check out Meebo, everyone who's here, if you haven't already. I'm trying this new rebalanced format of New Capenna Draft. It's going okay so far, although I think I might just die to this punt I just made. No, we're fine. We're fine. We're just going to pump our initiate. And then... are we throwing our car away in order to save our Kaldai Scrum Arm? I think maybe we're flunging. I think the flunge maybe here is actually okay. Yeah, sure. Let's find out. There's only one way to find out, right? By finding out. That block makes sense. That block makes sense. What are you doing about this? Just dying, huh? Okay, great. Yeah, so what we really wanted to do was crew the car, play this, pump the car, crew the car again, and then get in with whoever's left. So, yeah, that was the punt I made last turn. There's no opportunity to crew with a strong arm before the trigger?
No, yeah, you have to crew it with another creature. Like, you do have to crew the car twice, but that's something you can do with cars.
Okay, so our car is dead. Yeah, we just want to still make our buddy bigger here. Big buddy.
Yeah, we play this land.
Are we dead? This is 8 plus 3. No, we're not quite dead. They go to 2. We just hope to draw an instant here off of Blitz. There's things to kill us, though. We're dead to a pump spell.
Oh, we tapped wrong. Brutal.
We didn't cast a black spell, did we?
Auto tapper, why?
We're going to die to the auto tapper now.
Just another arena stream, baby.
Okay, they're gaining a life, which hopefully means they don't have another point of damage. It's only one creature that gets doubled, right? So 8, 9, 10, 11. Okay, none of this saves us. Or none of this saves them. But they get to get in for 8, and then they're chumping. They have to chump with Mr. Orfeo. So that we got that going for us. And then we can appear dead, but not lose to Deal Gone Bad. So that's dope. Sure, yeah, let's get... You get your chump on, please. It's too bad that this wasn't -4/-4, if we could win. Yeah, are we drawing a card? No, we don't have the mana for that, right? Yeah, we don't have enough. Okay. We might chump and then make another chump and scry. That's kind of hot. Well, I hope this works. It worked. Good. Should we scry? Tenacious Underdog. Terrifying. Oh, God. No, we're not scrying. It's okay. We have to draw a card. Leaving our black mana open, please. Secret good news. No, this isn't good enough, is it? We don't have trample.
Medicine pump, yeah. Oh, right. They can't block all of our creatures. Sorry. Yeah. Nope. I'm just slow. Thanks, team. I was, like, overthinking it. I kept thinking, like, they can block the Gold Hound if the Gold Hound attacks, and they can block the Vixer if the Vixer attacks. And I don't have enough blockers if I don't attack. Yeah. Hey, it's got Menace. Exactly. Okay, do we have time for one more game? Yeah. One more. Oh my god, team. Amaranth just went live, too. Has anyone been following this? This is, well, this Twitch streamer who has been all hot tubs and bikinis and stuff. And now she's doing a horse stream. I don't even know what that means, but apparently she's, like, taking her life back. And it's been a roller coaster. But good for her. Like, hope she's completely free of her abusive husband soon. You really like my tunic stream? Yeah, I'm looking forward to tomorrow. Yeah. Should have at least 3 more tunic streams. Maybe 4. We'll see. See how long. It takes us to get through all the puzzles and how much completion we want to go for. Auto tapper is evil, says V-Vosp. Yeah. Absolutely. Auto tapper, it left us double pump instead of being able to cast spells. It's true. We just couldn't use the double pump anymore. Okay.
Ooh. I mean, it's got some potential. We're on the draw. Honestly, this is some lands and spells. Like, this is a real loose keep, as they say. The keep doth be loose. The plays must therefore be tight. Alright. This one's the Thoughtseize. Sweet. Take your pick, bud. Yeah, I know, it's a pretty bad hand. They took the burn spell, fair enough. Your good friend kept a one lander and it wasn't even the color of the other spells in hand. There was a lot of swearing when they won that game. Yeah, that's what it's like. Magic's like that. Okay. Super awkwardly not gonna play this Kaldiah Strongarm or this Quick Draw Dagger, huh? I think that's correct. I mean, we could do it just a cycle. We have another Strongarm in our deck. Yeah. No, it's fine. It's fine. We need to take some game actions. Our opponent's hitting us for four in the sky. I mean, I guess we could just put it back in our hand instead. And just get in for four. Would we rather random card, or would we rather just... Yeah, sure, if we're just getting in for four, it's fine. We don't draw a card, but... You know, if we get some interaction aimed at our getaway car instead of our other creatures, I'm totally fine with that. Mm-hmm. Yeah, Evil Mono noticing that they took the card we couldn't cast. It's true. We have a mountain now. This is the card that was going to do the most against their deck. Countering my Thrag Test, buddy? No? I think I don't want to put this away now, but I might later. Okay, they took four. Super curious what their play is this turn. It is like drawing two cards in a turn or something. Yeah. This with actual Thrag Tusks, that would be fun. This is still good. Well, that's an instant, hey? Alright, so they're sort of drawing too. They get their Larcenus back after sacrificing it. Alright, and then... Well, what? And then nothing? Oh, brutal. Okay. 3 mana, mill some stuff. Put your card back in... Put your creature back in your hand. That's not how we drew it up. What? Are you gonna blow up my getaway car somehow? Take the double red one! It's actually really good against them. Okay,
Sorry, what? Which one was that? Yeah, I think the prize fight. Fair. Is this unblockable? No. Okay. Cool. Cool. I kind of like blitzing this because you get to shoot the larcenist. Nah, we're just attacking. Giada didn't attack. Okay. Are they countering it this time? Wasp says if this had actual threat test wording, he'd quit standard. Yeah. It's been years since Green had stooped so low to merely be good. Yeah. It's fair, Ukon. I think Green is, like, in a much more balanced place right now than it was, like, a year ago in standard. Seems like. Okay, now the creatures are attacking. Okay, and they've got a 4/5 flying. 5/6 because it's an angel. Sweet. Okay. Let's chill. I think we'll make a 6-power car. It's good, right? Okay, do we want to put this Call to Have Strong Arm back in hand or just draw a card? I think we draw a card, just get in. And I don't think we flicker this here either. Okay, well, they have 9 power in the sky, so that's scary. Do we have the mana to blitz this and cast this? If we rip a land, right? Yeah, if we rip any land, we can throw down both of these. Got it. Or I could go for the gain 3 life thing again. Is that going to be enough? No, not really, hey. Expensive time walk? That would kill me. Also dead to fog, untapped land. That's true, I have 4 non-basics that all come in tapped in this deck. And I haven't drawn any of them yet this game. I don't know, this is a weird one. It felt like things went badly enough for my opponent in the early game that maybe I was going to pull through, but I've been sort of dicking around with recasting creatures from Workshop Urshif, or because of Getaway Car. Okay, they obviously have removal spells. Yeah, I guess we do our thing, right? Make our big creatures attack with our stuff. Okay, we got to attack step. Is crew captain good enough? Swooping protector. Okay, you've got a second blocker. All right. Well, fair enough. I mean, they saw every card in our hand except for crew captain. So, I don't know. I kind of assumed that they were going to have good enough removal or combat tricks to beat us, but is what it is. Okay, I got to run off to a dentist appointment, team. Get my pearly whites. Look at all the stuff we won. I don't know. This format's okay. So far, I haven't been crushed by Bantex decks twice in a row, so I'll give it the salute for that. Plane shifted, new Capenna draft. Welcome, Raiders, one more time. We are going to take off, but thanks for dropping everyone off with us. Meebo, appreciate the exposure, and I hope that you had a great... I don't know if there is a time I'm walking this format laundry. I hope you had a great stream yourself. Where are we going? Let's drop in on Adam. It's always a good time. Looks like he's playing some League. Yeah, let's watch Adam play LOL. He's probably gaming out of his mind. Okay, thanks so much for joining. I also have a YouTube channel. It's Coach Nelly. I still haven't put the games up from last week. Sorry, I've had a busy life. You can find me on LRR as well if you don't know. Loading Ready Run, check them out. I'm Coach Nelly MTG on Twitch. And that's about all for my socials right now. I don't have any other stuff yet, but we're working on it. I'll be back here Thursday morning with Gladiator, which is 100-card singleton, if you're not familiar, on Arena. I'm a big proponent of those formats. Although I realized yesterday, shuffling at the tournament, I'm like, I could see playing a 60-card Australian Highlander in my old age, in my sunset years. Anyways, have a great rest of your day, and I'll catch you back here on Thursday or tomorrow morning on Loading Ready Run, playing some Tunic, if you want to stop by there. Okay, be good to each other. Free Iran!